Hey everyone, and welcome back. Mr. Steven here with Mr. Kevin, and let's get moving. We are going to work our bridging for 1 minute, and then without even pausing, we're going to go right into shrimping, forward shrimping for 1 minute. So it'll be 2 minutes straight. Let's start with our bridging. Let's get doing.
Echo! Play!
And go.
And seconds, keep moving.
And get ready to switch. All right, shrimping. Under the mat, but standing. 1 minute. And let's go. Using your feet to push. Readjust feet in front. Both sides, let's go. Use your feet to push. Pull out. Echo! Pause. So, very good. We were working on the top part of closed guard last class. This class, I want to focus back on bottom closed guard, but actually talk about it from more of a striking point of view. If someone is throwing punches. So, we still can use the same idea of standing in base, but we simply need to make sure that we are protecting ourselves from the punches, and use the right opportunity to get up. So if I have Kevin here. Again, if we're talking about a situation where we're allowed to strike, and there was a lot of space between us, it would make sense for me to try to get away, right? That'd be my friend. If we had this much room between us and I'm allowed to kick and punch, I would want to immediately boom, try to get my feet in between us so that I could kick and stand up on my feet. But assuming I can't do that, assuming that, you know, his weight's gonna come down with the punch, and I know that, and I have to be able to feel that right away, I'm gonna cover again with my forearms to my biceps, and, you know, putting the meat of my wrist on my ear, arm side to my face. I'm gonna tuck my chin, and I'm gonna, as I'm doing kind of a sit up, I'm also pulling with my legs. So he throws that punch, that strike, and I'm here, and I'm trying to pull his body in contact with my arms. And once I feel his body on my elbows, I can release to grip, to grab, to clinch. And there are different ways we can end up clinching, right? We'll end up on the one side. We often will end up with what we call an overhook and underhook, where my one arm will kind of be around his head. Especially when we think about here at the angle, my arms being on the inside of a punch, it makes sense that I will be able to wrap over and around and control his neck and, again, below the shoulder, above the elbow. I'll lift my head next to his head here and put pressure, my temple pushing into his head here, so he can't make contact with his left hand either, right? If I'm here and he leans back, maybe that left hand tries to strike, whereas if I can kite and I'll use my legs to pull and keep my head, but again, I'm not gonna stay here. Now, a very common reaction when pulling someone in is that they wanna strike, is to try to push up, to push himself back. And I'm not gonna just try to fight it, I'm gonna say, okay, I wanna go with it. If I feel can't push, I'm gonna try to come up. And really, I can come up on either side. The truth is, I could come up around his neck. It's just that at this point, he would have one, both his arms would be free, right? If he lifts up and I do come up, I have to keep weight on his neck as hard as I can to be able to work up to my hand and then lift between my backhand and opposing foot to my feet. If I choose to work on the overhook side right here, when I'm working my way up, I have to keep weight on the overhook. I have to try to transition my weight, which is right now, you know, on my back hand to opposing foot to that shoulder. So I will lift and I pull my foot back, but all my weight goes on that shoulder until I'm able to get my chest on the back of the head. Post. And get disengaged, run if I can. So again, we'll do this for just 1 minute. Super controlled. Really, the person who's on top. This first man, person on top, just gonna float nice and easy. Here. Again, Kev's gonna cover, he pulls me in, wraps me up. And really, you go either way. The choice is his. Boom, boom, back. That's it. We'll do this 1 minute. You can do this one. Striking again, nice and relaxed. Pulling the person in with your legs, covering, wrapping them up. It gives you a chance now to work with a little sense of urgency where the person's going to try to, you know, lightly make contact. And I have to try to be, you know, wrap them up a little bit more and make sure that I'm not, you know, leaving myself open and then work my way up again. You know, there's an absolute chance where in my attempt to stand up, my opponent blocks my initial attempt and exposes themselves to something that I'd want to attack. That's absolutely possible. And so in this exercise, if that happens, you can take advantage of it and try, you know, and say, oh, look, that person gives me something that's just right there. Because it is a more open positional sparring. But don't forget, the first priority is to end up on your feet with this exercise. So if you don't end up on your feet, you got to get to your feet. Don't stop. Even if I had like a armbar, I want to get up to my feet. All right? So 1 minute, last drill. Echo, play. Let's do it. Seconds. And time.
Echo!
Pause. Excellent job. So, obviously we want to be safe, but we have to be able to train with some level of contact and realism. Someone throwing strikes when we're on that bottom position is a real problem, but the underlying movement you get through grappling training without strikes gives you the ability to move and adapt when we add strikes. So great work. We hope everyone's having fun. As we said, it is finally coming, winding down, and I know we will be getting to see everyone on the mat soon. So, that being said, we'll stand straight. All right. And a sign of respect, we'll bow.